Welcome back to NetSuite Super Training. In this module, I'm going to be covering the various resources that are available to you for help on NetSuite. So there's a lot of different places you can go to get information on NetSuite, but there's three key repositories. The first one would be Super Training, these videos themselves. These videos are not made by NetSuite. These videos are made by SuperSync. You can find that online at supersync.cloud. And our purpose in making these videos is really to create some kind of videos that get people familiar with the software and really up and running with it. So that's Super Training. Then there's the Help Center that is made by NetSuite and is accessible from your NetSuite account. And the purpose of the Help Center is it has documentation, it's got manuals, user guides, so it's a resource for that. And then lastly, we have the Suite Answers site or page, which I'm going to show you. And Suite Answers is really a great resource for if you're trying to debug something, if you want help and trying to figure out how to do something, it's just a great place to go to. They have tons of videos and articles on solving or handling some specific problem. You can do searches, etc. So we're going to be covering all of these different things as well as some additional help resources in this module. In this particular lesson, I'm going to be going into detail on the Help Center. So let's take a look at that. All right, here we are on our home dashboard. So if we want to go to the Help Center, what we do is go over to the right here and we see this help button. So if we click on that, notice it opens a different page. We're no longer in our NetSuite instance. This is actually taking us to a totally different location. Similar to like if you're using the Employee Center, you're not able to do normal searches, you're not able to access your normal database of information. This is a completely different page. So just keep that in mind. If you want to go back to NetSuite, you do need to click back to your main tab up here. All right, the first thing I should talk about, you may not run into this at all, but just in case, because it does happen with a lot of people, if you come to this page and it's in German, don't worry, it happens to a lot of people. Just go over to the top right here and you'll see it says English. It can be a default setting for a lot of people where when you first get there, it's almost like it alphabetically selects the first language, which is Deutsch, German, and literally the whole page will be in German and people get very confused. So just go to the top right here, switch it to English. It's very simple. You get a little drop down here. Just make sure you have English selected and you'll be fine. So just in terms of orientation on the Help Center, on the left-hand side of the screen is this table of contents. You can go down, you kind of drill down. It's quite hierarchical. So we have like order management. We can go sales orders from there. And we've got all these options. So let's go to sales orders. And let's say we want to know how to create sales orders. So now that we've really drilled down into a subject, we actually get a page pull up here on the right, which is going to give us the information about what we're searching. So it talks, this is all documentation on creating sales orders. You know, it's got a little header for the specific types of sales orders you can create. And you can read through all of this. And it's got little notes, suggestions. It's also got these hyperlinks. Some of these, like sales order header fields, will sometimes it'll link you to a different section here so that the hyperlink will just take you to a later part of the article. And sometimes when you click on them, it will take you to an entirely different page in the Help Center that'll give you more information on that particular thing. So it just depends on what you're clicking, but you can kind of scroll through. It gives a lot of data, a lot of categories. Again, this is just a lot of documentation. It might not be exactly what you're looking for on creating a sales order, but it does have the basics there. And at the bottom, it always has this section that gives you topics related to whatever you just searched. So it gives you a lot of additional things. If you found maybe you have some more questions or it didn't just completely satisfy your answer, you can always take a little bit of a deeper dive in there. So let's go back here. So this is the, obviously we got the table of contents. We've got the main area here. Just scroll back up there. And then a couple other things we have here is, first off, I'd just like to kind of point out, we went straight from the home dashboard to the Help Center, but you can actually do something more specific. You can keep in mind, if we go back here, let's just pull up a record. Let's say this sales order. Okay, so let's say you're just kind of in NetSuite, you're on this sales order, there's some problem you're running into or you don't know either what you're dealing with or some difficulty you're running into. You can always go straight over here. The help button is always there. And if you click on that, Notice what it does. It doesn't just pull us to the home dashboard or the home page for the help center. It actually brings us specifically to a page referring to or related to the page we were just on in NetSuite. So we're on a page about sales orders. It brings us to a help center article about creating sales orders. So keep in mind, you can always kind of just go immediately from where you're at to a relevant, at least somewhat relevant article in the help center. On the help center, you also have this tab up here is user guides. If we click on that, it gives us a pretty exhausting amount of manuals and guides. Let's just click on one of these here, like fixed asset management. That can be, there's a lot to that subject. And if you click on that, notice, I mean, this thing is 155 pages long. Many of these manuals are hundreds and hundreds of pages long, and it really goes into a deep dive on these subjects. So especially for consultants or some more tech-savvy administrators who need some information on a particular area, you can always go to these user guides, and it does have quite a bit of information. There's a lot of other tabs here and resources. There's training. It takes you to the Oracle site. There's also some videos on the Oracle site. And then lastly, we do have this Suite Answers. If we want to go straight from the Help Center to Suite Answers, we can click on this tab to get immediately there. And that's it for the NetSuite Help Center. In the next video, I'm going to be covering the Suite Answers page. So I'll see you there.